The history of Phoenix and the 27 municipalities that make up the metro area has been a story of explosive population growth. Early Phoenix, established after the Civil War, was a small town, capturing water from the Salt and Verde rivers, as the ancient Ho-Kam had done centuries earlier, allowed agriculture to expand across the region through the 1950s. Since World War II, though, the primary land use change has been urbanization. The invention of air conditioning and the rise of the personal automobile facilitated Phoenix's booming growth. Today's Phoenix is a place that went all in on the 20th century suburban ideal. But now we ask, is this the future we really want? Rising urban heat, traffic congestion, air pollution, water scarcity, and a dry river are all problems we seek to remedy. There are also serious challenges ensuring social and environmental justice for all residents, a consequence of past racial and ethnic discrimination, especially in South Phoenix, a focus of CAP's more recent work. In Scenarios and Futures IRT, we assert that we need positive visions of the tomorrow we want in order to invest today in the strategies that will get us there. CAP LTER uses scenarios as both synthetic and visioning tools. Scenarios are narratives about the future of a place or a situation. The process is synthetic because scenarios can accommodate many different types of ideas, data, and knowledges that may be social, ecological, or technological. It is visioning because stakeholders imagine and spell out what a desirable future looks like. CAP LTER created 6 regional scenarios that explored sustainable solutions for the Central Arizona Phoenix region. 3 of these scenarios were adaptive scenarios in that they responded to a known issue in the Phoenix social, ecological, technological system, such as drought, heat, or flood. The other 3 were transformative scenarios, which are visions that try to push the boundaries of what we think is possible. For example, the Emerald City transformative scenario focused on reconfiguring land use and urban form to balance challenges of flood, drought, and heat. Freeways are imagined as multimodal transportation networks that bisect canals and create connected hubs that concentrate population density and vegetation. Key changes in this future are a reimagined transportation system that includes fewer personal automobiles and more mass transit. It also envisions more tree canopy cover and urban density. By 2060, this scenario imagines that the region relies on 100% renewable energy.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Marta Verbes, and I am a professor at the School for the Future of Innovation in Society. I was formerly a postdoc with the CAP LTER, and I want to welcome you to South Phoenix. We're here this morning. This was the site for our CAP for scenarios. And we wanted to focus at the community level and do bottom-up perspectives on the scenarios, and this is going to allow us to compare with the regional scenarios. So we have similar themes. Some are adaptive, the other ones are transformative. So we started with heat, but in South Phoenix we really focus on heat equity because we understand that heat doesn't affect everybody in the community the same way. In fact, we had a whole scenario that was dedicated to equity, and we called it the Equity District. Then we had a scenario that was called Connected and Mobile, and that scenario explored transportation, and in fact it explored the incoming light rail train that is going to be coming along Central, and that was hugely controversial at the time. The first scenario was the Just Green Enough scenario, which had to do with recognizing the need for nature-based solutions in this community, but also understanding that gentrification is a real issue here. And the last scenario was mountain to river. So South Phoenix is located between the South Mountain and Malbec and the Salt River. And this scenario explores the water flows, but also issues of identity and history. So we're here in South Mountain, which is the southern boundary of South Phoenix. And behind me is the city of Phoenix. And this is where we held our South Mountain community workshops. As well, we did some follow-up with the scenarios that were produced in those workshops. And one of the ways in which we follow up was we paired up with a design studio that was led by one of the faculties that is associated with the Design and Futures IRT. And I was one of the postdocs, along with some grad students, that got to work with the design students. And what we did, we gave to the students our scenarios, and we asked them to design things for us. And so what you see here are some of the designs that came out of that classroom that we later use in a workshop where we ask the community to prioritize which strategies were more doable, more desirable, and more transformative.
Hi, I'm David Proffitt. I'm a postdoc with the CAP LTER Scenarios IRT here. One of the first things that I've been doing as part of the Sustainable Future Scenarios team is extracting scenarios that have to do with reducing greenhouse gas emissions from the community scenario workshops. A lot of those have to do with creating more walkable places so that people can drive less, take transit more, reduce their exposure to heat, increasing public transit, and really connecting all of these things together in a way that creates networks of cool, shaded, walkable places so that people use less energy and produce fewer emissions to get around.
So we're here at the Rio Salado Habitat Restoration, and this is the northern boundary of South Mountain Village. So we did one more workshop where we asked participants, some of which had been at the original South Mountain Scenarios workshop, to decide amongst the strategies that were identified then and created by the students. And we used a Q-sort method to have them talk about which strategies were more durable, which strategies were more adequate, and which strategies were more transformative.
Hello, my name is Mark Hartman. I'm the Chief Sustainability Officer for the City of Phoenix. And I'm here to kind of talk about just briefly the benefits of the long-term scenarios with CAP LTER project and how the city really benefits from those. And primarily the idea of, you know, when we looked at the long-term plans, I think the most important part is actually just to articulate where we're headed to. It's really, as we look at our short-term plans, cities are often thinking in the few-year timeframe, it's really important to know the context of where we're going in the long-term, because it very much informs and kind of looks at, and you can see the gap of where we are and where we need to be. And it really encourages innovation when we see how far we need to go and what we need to do. And as well, I think that the one thing that I think the particularity this scenario planning work did for many of the participants, I mean, I heard a lot of this in comments, was people seeing what their cities could be and that vision of where they could go. And I think it was very valuable for all the participants. So thank you. Those are my brief comments on the work, and just that I really did appreciate it, and the City of Phoenix found it very valuable. So thank you very much.